Big Hole National Battlefield was established as a cultural site, but it's also home to the Lemhi penstemon, a rare blue flowering plant that not many people know about. The penstemon attracts pollinating insects. The insects and the flowers have been helping each other out for thousands of years. It's a fascinating relationship, and it's worth taking a closer look.
Yeah, there.
Big Hole National Battlefield was preserved for protecting the cultural landscape. As a consequence, the natural landscape, the native plants, animals, and insects are protected. Lemhi penstemon is a great example of this. It's a very rare plant that is still here in the Big Hole Valley in this park.
The species is designated as sensitive by the U.S. Forest Service and is also considered at risk of extinction by the Montana Natural Heritage Program. Some of the largest populations are found on the Big Hole National Battlefield, and that makes this site particularly important for the conservation of the Lemhi penstemon. There are several different kinds of insects that visit the flowers, mostly bees, but there is one very unique wasp that actually specializes in pollinating these flowers. It is known as a pollen wasp. Unlike common wasps, which typically hunt other insects or feed on your picnic food, these wasps behave more like bees.
The wasp is adapted, its body size is adapted perfectly to the whole flower. It actually crawls straight into the mouth of the flower, and it's doing two things. It's gathering nectar from the base of the flower tube, and then at the same time, pollen is also attaching to the body of the wasp. When the wasp is in the flower tube, you can hear this scraping as it's working its body back and forth in there when it's collecting the pollen. The visitation of the flowers by this wasp is essential really for the long-term persistence of the plants because it is such a good, well-adapted pollinator in this case.
The Big Hole Battlefield provides a special opportunity where we can combine the goals that we have for conservation of a rare species with the objectives for conserving the cultural significance of the site.
Each year we count Lemhi penstemon. June is the best time for us to do that when the plant is in flower. But we're down on our hands and knees, really crawling around looking for those seedlings, which are very hard to find, and the large, showy, flowering adult plants.
That seedling count's important because it gives you an idea of how well the population might be doing in a given year. When we have data over like a 10-year period, a longer time period, that really helps give us a good understanding of the population changes over time.
So Lemhi penstemon are not normally part of the visitor experience. They're flowers on the hillside. They're not related to the battle itself. So if visitors want to see Lemhi penstemon, they can walk on several different trails in the park, including the overlook. And Lemhi penstemon flowers early in the summer, usually late June, early July.
This is an essential part of being able to effectively to preserve and protect these resources for future generations. And of course, this is really the essence of the National Park Service mission.